Nigeria, this incredibly vast and populous land, literally overflows with wealth and abundance. This nation, knitting together an endless tapestry of cultures, colors, drums, rhythms, dance and drama, proverbs, wise words, and poetry, diverse and deep. But not just splendor, but passion and incomparable and unsuppressible energy. Nigerians, proud, dignified patriots, a people and a nation of immeasurable potential and achievements. As a leader in Africa, we have innovated, created, and succeeded time and time again. When others doubted, we believed in the manifest destiny of ourselves and our continent. Our faith remained strong that this is our moment.
Legendary B. Legendary B. Legendary B. Legendary B.
I get girls for my yard, they get big, big back away, they make me feel amazing, girl.
If I tell you, say I love you, oh. Party billion for the account, yo. Yeah. Versace and Gucci for your body, yo.
If there's a particular industry where Nigerian talent is best appreciated today, it certainly is in technology and creativity. In other words, entertainment, you know, entertainment, the whole gamut of entertainment, music, film, the whole, you know, gamut of entertainment. Everywhere you go in the world today, you hear Nigerian music, people are watching Nigerian movies, you know, our artists are popular the world over, they're, you know, doing great and exciting things. Challenges, difficulties, many. But our unfailing conviction that our God-endowed talents, resources, and resourcefulness has given us victory time and time again.
The first priority was to focus very heavily on enabling environment and what it would take to make it easy to do business in Nigeria, what it would take to make Nigeria the one of the preferred, if not the preferred destination for investment in Africa, and to make Nigeria one of the most attractive countries to do business in Africa and indeed the entire world.
Nigeria's population of 193 million people represents an interesting pool of potential customers or potential buyers for any investment opportunity.
The African Development Bank, they want to give us something in the order of about $500 million for our startup innovation fund. And the whole point of that fund, of course, is to enable entrepreneurs, young businessmen and women who are starting up businesses and all of that, to be able to tap into that fund so that they can quickly grow their businesses.
We have redirected our efforts to transform our economy, creating wealth, improving living standards, investing in our people, ensuring a stable and growing Nigeria for Nigerians, a thriving Nigeria for Africa, a prospering Nigeria for the world.
I see increased competition, you know, from the telecom and the IT and the fintech companies. You know. So the future of banking might not be in mortar and bricks, you know, it's in technology. You know, the banks are going to have competition from the telecom companies. It's going to get more intense. So the banking industry, as we know it today, will be radically different 10 years from today.
If you look at some of the technology-driven businesses, such as the fintechs and some of these companies that are doing mobile payments and all that, there is conflict with the banking sector. So there are issues around that. And part of the work that has given rise to the new regulations that the central bank is issuing with respect to payment systems and all that is because of the work that we're doing in the technology and creativity group.
We are implementing the Economic Recovery and Growth Plan, a practical plan painstakingly put together to drive an agricultural revolution, to power up our factories,
and light up our lives.
Soybeans, it's like oxygen to the Chinese. They import it the most. But if we are got in a collaboration on trade with the Chinese to develop plantations and to develop more soybeans, we can export it to them. We must let export drive our GDP. That is the only way we are going to survive. And I'm talking about non-oil exports.
With respect to agriculture, first we set a target for ourselves that will be self-sufficient in rice production. And we are really at the point where we hit that target. Imports of rice have dropped by close to 90%. As a matter of fact, we're only importing about 2% now. Official importation of rice is just about 2%. So it's really falling. And so a lot of the rice that we're producing at the moment is locally grown rice. So we're producing as much paddy as we need, but we're not milling as much as we need. So the milling industry is one where we're really investing heavily. And we're encouraging the private sector to invest. There are several people who are investing in various farm projects. They are producing incredible quantities of high quality tomatoes, high quality vegetables. And this is, you know, the sort of quality that is comparable to anywhere in the world.
Fufuo Limited is Nigeria's largest indigenously owned cashew processing company. Though we like to think of ourselves as a retail snacks business. We are producing from the farm all the way to the consumer.
We got into it with the belief that we'll be able to train our women to get share to the next level. In Nigeria alone, we're aware that our mothers used to use shea butter, Ori. The future for shea butter is very bright. It's bright in the sense that every cosmetic industry, nationally and internationally, they need shea butter. Shea is only from Africa.
To build our roads and railways, to move our people, goods and services swiftly and efficiently, and empower our people and small and large businesses.
We've done some work with solar power in our what we call our Energizing Economies project, where we are putting solar power in several markets, 300 markets in all. But the whole idea is that if you provide power for these clusters, then they can, without necessarily relying on grid capacity, they can carry on their own business and, you know, and do their own work as effectively as possible. We're also building other infrastructure. Railways, for example, we're building the Lagos Kano Rail, starting from the Lagos ports all the way up to Kano.
What is size without wonder and astonishment? 200 million people, innumerable ideas, limitless possibilities, wondrous abilities.
We must position export trade as an engine for economic growth. And that is what we really must do.
But we are more than size and scale. We are dynamic, motivated, vibrant, ever ready to take on the world. This beautiful nation, endowed with picturesque coastlines, pristine beaches, majestic mountains, great rivers, enthralling waterfalls and enchanted forests. This land of love, of peace and happy people, our wonderful nation, set to take its rightful place at the very top. Nigeria is here. We are here.